The Riverside and Great Northern Society is a nonprofit organization that was formed for the preservation and operation of the former Sandley Light Locomotive Works at the Wisconsin Dells. The Sandley Works built miniature live steam trains and equipment for parks and zoos from the 1940s to 1980. At that time, the shops went bankrupt and the property was foreclosed on. In 1988, a group came together to save the works and persuaded the bank into letting them reopen the 15-inch gauge railroad as a not-for-profit organization. Restoration work continues on the shops, and trains operate on a schedule. Much of the work is performed by members that volunteer their time and skills.
You kind of find projects around here. I mean, the idea was...
White's hot?
Yeah.
Okay.
And my black is neutral, so if I just
back in here and cut it. I know that, but I want to take this part. Short this out, and we get the little axe in there, we get the bells going.
Visitors may ride the 15-inch gauge railroad that takes them on a 3-mile round trip through the wooded natural area of the Wisconsin Dells. This year's Iron Horse Roundup consists of 3 Stanley-built locomotives. The number 1916 is visiting from the Milwaukee Zoo. Built in 1961 for the Milwaukee Journal, the newspaper presented her as a gift to the zoo. The name Harry J. Grant on her cab is in honor of one of the paper's important people. Locomotive number 1916 still pulls trains to the zoo, but this weekend they have loaned her and 4 coaches to the RGN's roundup. Turntables are located at each end of the line so the locomotives may be turned before making the returning trip. Saturday brings the steaming up of all 3 locomotives, the number 1916, number 98, and number 82. Locomotive number 82 was the first engine built for the Milwaukee Journal and was given to the zoo in 1957. In time, the zoo received the number 1916 and the even larger Pacific class number 1924, which took on the task of running the longer trains that became necessary as the railroad increased in popularity. Engine number 82 was then retired and placed on display. With the reopening of the RGN Railway, the zoo was persuaded into trading number 82 for a diesel engine at the RGN. She's been their main locomotive ever since. The battery-powered section gang speeder car provides workers a way to race to where they may be needed on the line. Today's crew is heading out to remove falling leaves from the tracks.
By the Riverside and Great Northern Preservation Society, a non-profit educational corporation with about 160 members, and always looking for a few more.
At Camp Siding, RGN members demonstrate how a train order hoop would be used to pass orders to the crew on a moving train. Thank you.
1916, engineer, go ahead, dispatch.
1916, you are authorized to proceed from Western Springs into 59th Street Siding. Hold at 59th Street.
Roger, 59th Street Siding.
Yep, by hand. I thought the engine would do it, but bring the whole train out this way.
The third steamer in use at this roundup is number 98. This engine was built in 1952 for the Hoot, Toot, and Whistle Railroad in Elgin, Illinois. After the train ride closed down around 1982, locomotive number 98 was purchased by the city of Knoxville, Tennessee for their zoo. With the removal of the railroad in 1988, Dalton Schrock bought the engine for his use on his old Wakarusa Railroad at the Come and Dine restaurant in Wakarusa, Indiana. It operated there until the passing away of Mr. Schrock in 2001. A member of the RGN obtained the engine from the Schrock family and brought her to the Dells in 2002. After operating for the 2002 Iron Horse Roundup, she went in for a major overhaul. The name D.R. Schrock was added to the side of the cab in honor of her last owner. Today, she makes her debut.
Conductor 98 to engineer 98, highball at will.